We ask you to continue to pray for our pastor, our first lady, his family, all the saints of God everywhere, those that are here, those who aren't able to make it this morning, those desire to be here and not able to come, those that don't desire to be in the house of the Lord, looking for a reason, they found it, amen? But when you realize who you're serving, and you realize what he went through and how he pressed his way to bring us together, it gives you, it should motivate you to want to continue, to press a little harder. God is able to keep us, regardless of the time, the weather. God can keep us today if you really want to be kept. And it's good to know you got a God that's able. Amen. Pray for those that are sick among us, those in the hospitals. Remember the souls here on the altar, those in the neighborhood here. God, touch. Let us be a light, shining bright. And men and women that come in, young people that come in to the house of the Lord to serve the Lord. They come in wanting to bring their talents and give themselves back to God. And we can serve him the way he wants us to serve him. Right now, if you have any requests, we want you to make them known to the church. Speak loud so the church can hear you. Everyone here can continue to help you pray. Sister Tracy.
Continue to pray for me. Continue to pray for my family. Continue to pray for those who speak in the Holy Ghost. Continue to pray for church to be filled. Continue to pray for our vision. For all of the buildings.
Thank you, Jesus.
Pray for the young people when we go on our winter break this week. Pray for us by the church of Jesus. Pray my spirit in the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Are there any more requests? Amen. Is there another request? Just a glad.
I'd like to thank you for the United States family. I saw Christian Jesus in the home and pray this world and make it up to us.
Amen. Are you all paying attention to all the requests as they come forth? Are we paying attention?
Amen.
Listen to the other's requests. Amen. If we're saying the same things, we got our minds focused on Jesus for God to give us the block. And we pray to that effect. God will.
Amen.
If it's his will, he'll do it.
Amen.
If we're willing to work, do his will. Praise the Lord, Brother Ken. Amen. Are there any more requests? Sister Hope.
Pray for the leaders that are sick, our pastor, former pastor, also the young child from Belleville, I guess, that has cancer in the brain.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Remember my family also. We want the Lord just the best of service throughout today. Amen. Reach out and touch the Lord as he goes by. You will find he's not too busy, then he won't hear your heart's cry. He is mad by each moment. All you need, he will supply. So reach out as he goes by. Well, just reach out. bless us one more time that we can come together as one into thine house and bring the praise and glory and honor to thy precious name. Oh, Father, we ask that thou will continue to bless the church as a whole. Bless the man of God and his family, Lord. Each and every request that have come forth this morning, bless right now. We know that you're more than able. Help us, Lord, to be encouraged this morning, to continue, Lord, to praise you, to continue to serve you, to let thy will be done in our lives this morning. Bless thy children everywhere. Hallelujah, those that are here, those on the way, those not able to be here, Lord, you know and understand. You're able to keep us, Lord, if we want to be kept this morning. We thank you for the victory, hallelujah, that we've won already through Christ. Hallelujah, we thank you, Lord, for blessing our souls this day with your word. We thank you, Lord, for what our ears are about to receive and hear. Help us to hear from our hearts, Lord, to receive thy word. Hallelujah, we thank you right now. Bless, oh God, right now this morning. Bless each and every child, each and every one that's here. Hallelujah. Let thy spirit, Lord, prevail in this place. Let the men and the children to hear thy words. Hallelujah. Let them receive it, Lord, as the word of God. We thank you right now for your blessings. Have your way, Lord Jesus. Let the spirit of the Lord move throughout this place. In the name of Jesus. Fill up thine house, Lord. Bless every soul that comes in the door. In the name of Jesus. Save, Lord Jesus. Say today, in Jesus' name, amen. Psalm 56, in responsive reading. I want you to turn to it, Psalm 56, responsibly. We come to praise the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. No sad story. We come to praise the Lord. Psalm 56, in responsive reading. You have to say amen. Be merciful unto me, O God, for man would swallow me up. He fighting daily oppresseth me.
My enemies would daily swallow me up. There may be many that fight against me, O thou most high.
What time I am afraid, I will trust in thee.
In God will I praise his word. In God have I put my trust. I will not fear that flesh can do unto me.
Every day they bewitch. Bless my words. All their thoughts are against me for evil.
They gather themselves together. They hide themselves. They mark my steps when they wait for my soul.
Shall they escape by iniquity and thine anger? Cast down the people, O God.
Thou tellest my wandering. Put thou my tears into thy bottle.
Yes.
They are naughty. Are they not in my bottle?
When I cry unto thee, then shall mine enemies turn back. This I know, for God is for me.
In God will I praise his word. In the Lord will I praise his word.
In God have I put my trust. I will not be afraid when man can do unto me.
Thy vows are upon me, O God. I will render praises unto thee.
And 13 altogether. For thou hast delivered my soul from death. Wilt not thou deliver my feet from falling, that I may walk before God in the light of the living. And may the Lord have a blessing. The reading of his word. Can you say amen again?
Amen.
Amen. I said it again. We come to praise the Lord.
Amen. I got it way down, deep down, deep down in my heart. Yes, I got it way down.
I'm who's here.
Hallelujah.
Praise him for who he is. Hallelujah. You see, you can tell when somebody's got it in their heart.
You forget about the crowd
who's sitting out there looking at you, who's staring, and you forgot to turn your ring low. And you go ahead and praise him for yourself. Because of who he is. Let's look at him.
We are the soldiers in the army.
We have to fight. Although we have to try. We got to hold.
Like how you can depend on, you know, God.
Right.
I can depend on my parents and some stuff, but you know.
God gets you through so much, and sometimes you forget why you're going through what you're going through. That God can bring you out. Or
yes.
Even if you're going through it, no matter how bad your situation is, even if you go through what you don't want to go through, the worst possible happens,
yes.
God has something for you
mm-hmm.
at the end of it. So I just thank God for being
there. Amen. She's one of my friends that I've been praying for.
Amen.
And I didn't realize she was in Sunday school. I turned around and saw her. Elsa made me hit her on the arm. I didn't know she was here. It's a good thing that you can go away and come back still want to serve the Lord.
Amen.
You won't let nothing stop.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Regardless of where you're at.
Amen.
Serve him anyhow. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Everybody don't have that testimony. You can go away and come back and still.
Hallelujah.
You want to praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Is there another praise? It's another praise. We're going to move on if you don't stand. We're going to move on. Our ushers, praise the Lord. Just praise.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I just want to testify that when Sister Glenn and Sister Jay said that God is good all the time, I thank him for loving me, for keeping me. Thank you, him, for the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you, him, for a church that's preaching truth. Excuse thank you, him, for being there all the time. Thank you, him, for protecting my children, whether they know who's protecting them or not. I'm thanking him for just being there when Keon's parents caught on fire, that his skin didn't get burned. I just thank God he covered Keon.
Amen.
He's been baptized, but he doesn't have the Holy Ghost. But he's been covered by the blood.
Amen.
He didn't get burned, but his pants got burned. I thank God for just sealing, just putting his blood all around our cars and protecting us when we're driving out here.
That's right. Yeah.
Thanking God that she spun out yesterday and she could have hit somebody here. And then somebody spun in front of her that could have hit my car. I just thank God for his grace.
Amen.
I thank him just for the blood. I don't know why. This is my testimony every Sunday. I don't know why he loves me. But thank you, Lord. Thank you. I'm glad you do.
Amen.
I don't deserve to be here, but I'm glad I'm here. Pray my strength in the Lord.
Amen. You say amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Let's hear from the musicians. Sister Ashley Hope.
Praise the Lord. Thank God for being here. Thank God for another day, another opportunity to praise him. I thank God for being good. Just thank God for keeping me, keeping my family, keeping my church family,
Amen. And
having a mind to want to praise him and to serve him.
Right. Amen. Amen. Let me say no more stands, please. Brother Kia.
Lord,
Amen. Now, First Lady, Sister Hope.
Precious, he is my Lord and King. He is my
Jesus, amen. Amen. Jesus is so precious. Amen. Precious to me.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Truly God is everything in our lives.
Amen.
He wants to be everything in our lives. I'm learning each and every day how to serve Him and praise Him more and more. That's my testimony. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Thank you and praising the Lord for another day. Another day that I didn't see before. God has blessed the spirit of my life. And I'm happy about that. I'm happy that I know who the Lord is. He's teaching me. He's taken all my life, all this time, which I may think is long, but it's not. And God has showed me. I thought He's going to show me other people. He keeps showing me.
Amen.
And I'm glad about that. Because when you really want to be right before the Lord, He'll show you yourself. And it helps you get out the way and get in God's way.
Amen.
And I'm just so glad God is still working things in and out of me. It's just a blessing to have a Savior like this.
Amen.
He's worthy to be praised.
Amen.
Again, we thank the Lord for all the testimonies. Can you shout, hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
Now shout it to Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thanks unto the Lord. Right now we're going to receive Sister Ashley Hoke with the announcements. Receive her by saying amen.
Amen.
Amen. Sister Hoke. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Word of Power Ministries is having their Christmas dinner this afternoon at 2 p.m. Adults is $15. Children 7 years to 12 is $7. Also, at 5 p.m., they will be having their Christmas concert with the Word of Power Voices of Praise, Youth Praise Dancers, and special organ selections by Bishop Benjamin S. Hoke, Sr. Also, Bethel Church is having their Youth Empowerment Service this afternoon at 4 p.m. with Elder James Tyson II, I believe he is. His grandfather's the first. Apostolic Church of Jesus announcements are as follows. We will be having youth prayer on Tuesday at 7 p.m. There will be no Christmas dinner this year, but we will be planning for next year.
Yeah.
Ministers meeting is on the 29th at 7 p.m.
Yeah.
Pastor will be celebrating his 73rd birthday on the 30th. And watch night has been moved up 30 minutes. We're not going to have it at 9:30. Instead, we will have it at 9 p.m.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen?
And it will not be a regular watch night service. We'll be having Bible class that night.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
So, but we still want you to invite your friends and your family to come and join us in our last service of the year.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
We are online.
Amen.
Y'all sound happy.
Amen.
We are online.
Amen.
We are putting the word out on the World Wide Web so the worldwide can know the truth of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. ACJesus.net. Like us on Facebook. Friend us on Facebook. Follow us on Twitter. And watch us live on Ustream. And subscribe to us on YouTube. We are also still reading the Bible in a year.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen?
ACJ Youth is heading this up. How many are caught up? Where are we? Amos 1 through 3 and Revelation 6. That's the reading for today. Amen?
Amen.
Weekly schedule is as follows. Monday night, Hour of Power.
Amen.
At 7 p.m. Don't forget to fast, midnight to 4. Wednesday night Bible class at 7 p.m. Don't forget to fast, midnight to 4. Thursday night choir rehearsal at 7 p.m. Everybody ought to go too. The mamas and the papas in. Everybody ought to go too. At what time? 9:45 a.m. and Sunday morning service at 11:30 a.m. Please keep hold of your bulletins. They give you the schedule for the year as well as the prayer list for people to keep in mind to pray for. Also, on the back of your bulletins, there's a little barcode. It's called a QR code. If you tell somebody that we have a Facebook page, they would like to get in contact with us, they can take a picture of the barcode. Amen. And go right to the page and friend the church. Amen. These have been your announcements. Please govern yourselves accordingly. Amen. This choir is not here yet. You all about to be my choir.
Amen.
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 We don't have choir here today. So congregation. It's going to sing. Y'all ready to sing?
Yeah.
You gave me my hands to reach out to man, to show him your love and your perfect plan. You gave me my ears. I can hear your voice so clear. Can hear the cries of sinners, but cannot wipe away their tears. You gave me my voice to speak your word, to sing all your praises to those who never heard. But with my eyes for more availability, I see hearts that have been broken, so many people to be free. Lord, I'm available to you. My will I give. Church of Jesus, voices of praise, come and render unto us through selection.
Cries of sinners, but can I wipe away their
Do what you say, do you? Thank you. us that we are again gathered in this house. There are those that are absent this morning for one reason or another. We want to remember Sister Molden today, that the Lord will bless her. Her family is out of town on this day. Her ride to church is out of town, so we want to pray for her and remember her in prayer. Remembering Whitby in his absence, that God will certainly bless him and others that are absent from the house of the Lord. That the Lord will bless them, their son is absent. I know not the reason, but nevertheless, we thank God for them, for we know God is still able and he's still working in the house of the Lord. We thank God for the choir. Amen. We thank God for doing a great job singing the songs of Zion. We want you to continue to pray for them. I still think about when we went over to New Hope and they had to sing. They opened their mouth and they sang. They didn't just sing, they sang. They did an awesome job, and we're very proud of them as they go forth singing the songs of Zion. Just don't want you to forget who you're singing for.
Amen.
I want you to pray for me this morning. God will have his way in that which we say this day. We know that this is one of those cold days, snowy days. Got to get out in 6 inches of snow. It's not always comfortable.
Yeah.
It's not like going to the factory to make some extra money. And so this is one of the days you can stay home and you don't have to go. But if there's 6 more inches tomorrow, you got to go to work. Amen. But God is good anyhow.
Amen.
You know, one of these days we're going to really understand the goodness of God. I want to talk to our people. We don't need to be tearing off pieces of paper for visitors. We got to get cards. We can't wait till Sunday morning to find out we don't have cards. Visitors cards. And so we got to tear papers off to our visitors. That don't look good.
Amen.
We either lazy or we don't care. One of them is happening. Amen. So we can't go another day without getting what we need. I try to keep those things that we need in the house of the Lord, but the pastor can't see each and everything that is needed. Amen. That's why God help.
Amen.
Won't you remember Sister Hoke? She's traveling today. I forgot where she went, but anyway, she's traveling. And we want you to pray for her. The Lord will bless her as she travels and give her a safe journey. She's supposed to return home today, but we don't know exactly what time it is. But that we pray that God will give her a safe journey, for the storm is a large storm across the nation. And so we want things to be well. I don't think Sister Harris has returned back to Texas as of yet. I want to pray for them. I want to pray for all of those of Apostolic Church of Jesus, that God will certainly test their heart and give them an understanding of what he has done for them, so that they can make real choices of how they're going to serve God. At this time, we're going to get into the word of the Lord, and we want you to turn with us to Romans, the 11th chapter of Romans. The 11th chapter of Romans. First of all, I'd like to put this in, forgot it. We'd like to welcome our visitor in the house of the Lord, Sharnika Enright. Is that right? Sharnika Enright. Would you please stand?
Amen.
We want to welcome you into Apostolic Church of Jesus. Amen. On Plainview. Amen. We're happy to have you with us in the house of the Lord. We hope that you've enjoyed yourself thus far and you found a comfortable place in the house of the Lord. And we invite you to come on back.
Amen.
There's a lot that God has in store for you. Amen.
Amen.
We trust that they have given you a Bible, and we want you to turn to Romans, the 11th chapter of Romans. In the 30th verse, it reads like this. For as ye in time past have not believed God, yet have now obtained mercy through their unbelief. Even so have these also now not believed, that through your mercy they also may obtain mercy. For God hath concluded them all, in unbelief, that he might have mercy upon all. Oh, the depth of the riches, both of the wisdom and knowledge of God. How unsearchable are his judgments, and his ways past finding out. For who have known the mind of the Lord? Or who have been his counselor? Or who have first given to him? And it shall be recompensed unto him again. For of him, and through him, and to him are all things. To whom be glory forever. Amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you. And we praise you for your kindness. We thank you for your love. We thank you for strength this day to stand before thy people. We give you glory and we give you honor, for thou art worthy. Thou hast brought us out of darkness and into thy marvelous light. Thou hast given us truth that we may walk therein. Teach us, Lord, to receive it with gladness in our hearts. Teach us how to show forth our desire to walk with thee. Bless now, Lord, these that are gathered in your house this morning. Feed their souls. Give them that which they seek, and help us to draw close. Bless those that are sick and afflicted. Bless those that were not able to get into your house this day. Reach your hand out to them. Bless them. Encourage them. And Lord, those that are traveling, let your hand of mercy be with them. And we give you praise, glory, and honor right now. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. We're thanking God for this season. We're still talking about the reason for the season. People talk about it, but they haven't come to the understanding. People talk about Jesus, but they don't understand Jesus. I don't know how many of you have paid attention to the controversy that has come across the TV. The commentator said that Jesus is a white man, and Santa, y'all know Santa, don't you? He's a white man, too. I want you to understand, people say all kinds of things not knowing who Jesus is. I care not whether Santa, black, white, purple, or green. And those who would desire Jesus to be white, that's their desire. They want him to be white, fine. But do you know him?
All right.
Those who want him to be black, so he's black.
Right.
Do you know him?
All right.
And what difference does it make?
That's right.
If he's black or white?
Yeah, that's right.
We have to understand what he came for.
All right, that's right.
Not what color he came in.
Mm-hmm.
As we take notice of the scripture, you have to have some background to understand what Paul speaks of in the 30th verse. He says, "For as ye in times past have not believed God, yet have now obtained mercy through their unbelief." Paul is talking to the Roman church, the Gentiles that attended the Roman church, and all those that attended. And when he says these, he speaks of his own. And his own is the Jews. The Jews did not receive Christ when he came. They had a particular idea of Christ and his coming. Christ, to them, was their Messiah. Messiah and Christ means the same thing. Messiah is Hebrew. Christ is Greek. They had an idea that when Christ would come, he would deliver them. Not necessarily from the sinful state that they existed in and do now, but that he would free them from their enemies. And he really did come to free them from their enemies. But the problem being, they don't know who the enemy is. I believe in Ephesians, the 6th chapter, and the, I think it's about the 12th verse, says, "We fight not against flesh and blood."
Mm-hmm.
It says we wrestle.
Yeah.
Same thing as fight. Uh-huh. Not against flesh and blood, but against principalities,
uh-huh,
against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Now, our nation, which calls itself a Christian nation,
mm-hmm,
even itself is confused. They did not establish a Christian nation. What they established was a nation where you could worship God as you choose. You could decide how you would worship God. Bad, good, or in between. And you could serve any God that you desire to serve. It was not set up to make you serve God, the true and living God. If you want to be a Muslim, you can be a Muslim. And most folk don't even know what the Muslims believe. They believe in Abraham's God. They just don't know who Abraham's God is. They go by one so-called prophet called Muhammad. He wrote the whole Quran by himself and said he spoke for God. But God had several prophets, many writings prophets.
Yes, sir.
That wrote over about 16 centuries.
Mm-hmm.
They wrote. And as they wrote the scriptures, they did not confer with one another. But they wrote about the same one. They wrote about the living God. And the living God was he that moved upon them with his Holy Spirit. To get back to our text this morning, he says, even so have these also not believed, that through your mercy they also might obtain mercy. Here Paul is talking about Israel, the Jews, and he's also referring to the Gentiles. The Jews were the ones that was expecting Christ, was looking for Christ. And in looking for Christ, they were not looking for him to give them necessarily the salvation of their soul.
That's right.
But they were looking for God to give them salvation for their flesh. They wanted salvation, or they wanted freedom from their natural fleshly enemies. Those nations that are around them. We don't even pay attention today. The things that are happening in the Middle East are not just happening. Iraq doesn't want just to all of a sudden want to get rid of Israel since 1948. And Iran all of a sudden did not start hating Israel all of a sudden. And Egypt didn't all of a sudden begin to hate Israel. But they have been hating that country for a long time. And they wanted to take it for a long time. They have a right to the land because God drew out the nation of Israel and scattered them across the world. But Israel had a longing to get back to the land. You might be living in this world, but you're not paying attention to what's going on in the land. You're thinking that what is happening is just normally going to happen. You can do what you want to do when you want to do it. Life is going to continue. But I want you to understand, things are coming to a screeching end real soon. What was happening here? Paul was telling the church at this time that the Jews, because they did not believe Christ, it was to our advantage that they did not believe Christ. It was for us that they could not see Christ in his great mercy. What are you talking about, Elder Hoke? Had they known who Jesus is, had they known who he was at the time that he walked here on the earth, we probably never would have had the blood of Jesus shed upon Calvary's cross. Lord, have mercy. But through the blindness of their eyes,
hallelujah.
Through their unbelief, because they would not believe the prophets, neither accepted the miracles of God.
Yes,
and would not hear the miracles that God sent you. The word that he spoke to them. They refused to accept the living God. You see, Jews, glory, hallelujah, they don't want to accept Jesus. Because if they accept Jesus, they have to confess that they killed their Messiah. And for them to say they killed their Messiah would be saying they killed their God. For their God told them he would come. Glory, hallelujah. And when he come, the blinded eyes would be opened. And certainly when Christ came, he opened the blind man's eyes. He said the lame would walk. Glory, hallelujah. I want you to know the lame did walk. But they did not believe God. That was to our advantage. Glory,
hallelujah.
And because they did not accept Christ, God turned to the Gentiles.
Yes, sir.
And accepted them. He concluded all the Jews and all the Gentiles all together in sin.
Yes, sir.
Glory, hallelujah. I might need some more strength in my body.
Thank you, Jesus.
It says, for God has concluded them all in unbelief, that he might have mercy upon all. Look here. The Jew can be no more be saved than me, than us. They can no more get to God than us. We have to, as they do, receive Christ. If Christ had not gone to the cross, the Jew would not be saved, neither would the Gentiles. Now, when the Jews say that they're going to be saved, I want you to understand they are going to come to the realization of who Jesus is. For God has not forgotten his people. He knows who they are. But this time, it's for all of us, the Jew and the Gentile. It's our time to be saved. It's our time to receive Christ. And we've got to understand, Christ is not just another prophet, but he is very God, manifest in the flesh. Lord, have mercy. He's brought it down. The middle wall of partition that was between us. Glory, hallelujah. The reason he was born in Bethlehem of Judea. Glory, hallelujah. He wanted no man to be lost. My Bible tells me God would have all men to be saved. Glory, hallelujah. But God is not going to make you be saved. He's not going to make you come to him. It's more to life. Lord have mercy. Than what we see in this existing world. Glory, hallelujah. God has so much more in store for us. We're searching for grandeur in this present life. We got to get our mind off of it. I hope some of you will become great in this life. I hope some of you will become very rich. I hope some some of you will get to the place of high office. But wherever God takes you, wherever God sets you, take Jesus along with you. Take him to the highest office. Glory, hallelujah. Take him to the lowest job. Tell them Jesus died. Tell them that God died for us. Tell them he not only died, but he rose up again. Hallelujah. We want God to bless us. And the blessings that we want God to bless us with is the natural blessings. People look to God, and he's not God unless he gives me what I want. He must not be God if he doesn't hear my call. The problem is, we want God to hear our call, but we don't want to hear his call. We want God to know what we want, but we don't want to know what God wants. Glory, hallelujah. We feel that God is estranged from us. That is, he doesn't understand what we are going through. He doesn't understand the problems that we have. We have need of natural material. Turn with me to Matthew, the 6th chapter. Let me show you that God understands. The 6th chapter of Matthew. The 25th verse. Reads us the hope.
Therefore I say unto you.
Therefore I say unto you.
Take no thought for your life.
Take no thought for your life. In other words, we think God saying, just live and die. No, we're so concerned about life itself. I don't want to be in the cold. I want to sit down at a table with food on it. I want a home that has a bed in it where I can lay down and be warm. I want clothes to wear. God just says, take no thought for it. Don't be so overly concerned about it. That's what he's saying. Don't be overly concerned. You know, you have to really meditate upon what the scriptures are saying. Don't be overly concerned. We are so concerned that we cannot understand what God is saying. Read.
Therefore I say unto you,
take no thought for your life. Take no thought for your life.
What ye shall eat.
What ye shall eat.
Or what ye shall drink.
Or what ye shall drink.
Nor yet for your body.
Nor yet for your body.
What ye shall put on.
What ye shall put on.
It is not the life.
Is not the life.
More than meat.
More than meat.
And the body than raiment.
And body than raiment. Isn't there more to life than just these particular items in life? Of what I'm going to eat, what I'm going to put on, is that the extent of your existence? Is that the extent that you see what I'm going to put on, what I'm what I'm going to eat? Does your mind only go that far? You haven't looked beyond that. That's what God is saying. That's what he said, take no thought for it. He's not telling you you don't have to eat. He's not telling you you don't need clothes. He's not telling you you got to look nice. That's not what he's telling you. He said, don't be over concerned with it. Don't be wrapped up in this that you can't hear what I'm saying. Read. He said, look at the fowls in the air.
Well, they sow not.
They sow not.
Neither do they reap.
Neither do they reap.
Nor gather into barns.
Nor gather into barns.
Yet your heavenly Father feedeth them. Are ye not much better than they?
You mean God has more concern with feeding them than he does you? It's time to find out what is it that God is desiring. That's what God is saying. Life is more than that. Life is more than just going through it. God's got a purpose. Come on now. Than you just being rich. God's got a purpose. Than you just being poor. Come on now. And you being concerned with either one. The rich man is so rich. He ain't got time for God. The poor man is so poor. You can't tell him about God. He's too hungry. He ain't got no clothes. And you're going to tell him he needs to be saved. Give me some money. Read.
Which of you,
by taking thought, can add one cubit to his stature?
Why take ye thought?
For raiment.
Consider the lilies of the field. How they grow. They toil not. Neither do they spin.
Spin. What is a spin? Listen. Look around you. See what God has provided for the world. When you serve God, that's what God is telling you. He says, I'll fix it for you. I'll supply your need. But we want God to supply our need without us giving to God that which he desires from us. God wants to bless us with the knowledge of who he is. Come on now. But I can get so hungry that I can't hear nothing unless I smell some food. I'm so cold. I don't want you to do nothing but give me some clothes so I can get warm. There's nothing wrong with that. It's just that when you get the clothes, when God provides it for you, what will you do after that? Will you accept him in his greatness? Read.
And yet I say unto you
that even Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. He wasn't looking like one of those lilies. In all of his greatness, he didn't look good as a lily. Read.
Wherefore? God so clothed the grass of the field.
Wherefore, if God so clothes the grass of the field,
which today is,
and tomorrow is cast into the oven,
shall he not much more clothe you?
O ye of little faith. You know, once God give us what we have, we soon forget who gave it to us. I worked for this. You didn't work for that. God gave it to you. Come on now. There's a lot of folk doing what you do and don't have what you have. Come on now. There's a lot of folk smarter than you. And they're not working as hard as you, and they got more than you got. Don't think you that smart. You got to understand the provisions that God makes. God sets you in places to come to a place that you might learn of Him. Read.
Therefore, take no thought.
Don't be over concerned.
Saying, what shall we eat?
What shall we eat?
Or what shall we drink?
Or what shall we drink?
Or wherewithal?
Or wherewithal?
Shall we be clothed?
Now, you say, preacher, you don't understand. You got to understand. I've been hungry and didn't know where the next mouthful was going to come from. I've been broke and was wondering, Lord, how I'm going to pay my bill? Lord, if I don't pay this bill, they're going to take everything I got. Lord, if I don't get this paid, I'm going to lose my business. What am I going to do, Lord? Lord, you got you. Then I have to stop and say, wait a minute. Because I was really concerned. Hey, I was looking at disaster. I was looking at losing everything and my family and everybody else around me was going to lose. I had to walk the floor in the middle of the night asking God, how am I going to make it? And don't you know God provided? I don't even know when He provided. I tried to see what changed. I tried to see what came about. And I can't figure it out. All I know is that God provided. Glory, hallelujah. Read it just a little further.
After all these things,
do the Gentiles seek?
For
your heavenly Father knoweth. He said, He knows that you got need
of all these things.
He knows you got need. He knows you got need of it. He's not oblivious that you need these things to live. He knows you don't want to be in the cold. You just don't understand God. Read.
But seek ye first
the kingdom of God
and His righteousness.
And all these things shall be added unto you. He said, come and find God first. Seek God out first. But see, God has to do things in a backward way. Sometimes. So God sometimes will feed you. He will give to you. And then bring you to the place of understanding. And then you begin to think that you've got all that on your own. And if I got it on my own, I'm not going to give it up to God. I got this. And I got to keep that. Then if you got it, if you ain't got it, Lord have mercy. When God give it to you, you think you did it by yourself. If you got it, you're too rich to serve God. Glory, hallelujah. But God is so great. Lord have mercy. It says God has concluded them all in unbelief, that He might have mercy upon all. He says, oh, the depth of the riches, both of the wisdom and knowledge of God. How unsearchable are His judgments and His ways, past finding out. Once you begin to rest on God, you're going to have some times that you're going to want to do things your way without considering God. You're going to figure out how I can do it without God. Come on now. I'm going to do this myself. What you don't know is that God could touch and you can't do nothing. You can't even get out the bed. I've been there. Done that. Wasn't able to do it for myself. But I had to call on God.
Hallelujah.
Lord, have mercy. And God gave me what I need. He's so great. He makes provisions. We try to see tomorrow. But the song says, I don't know about tomorrow. Glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I don't know what's going to happen. But I know him that holds tomorrow.
Yes, sir.
Glory, hallelujah. Let's go back in Romans. Read for me the 33rd verse.
Oh, the depth
of the riches.
Both of the wisdom
and knowledge of God. It's great what God knows. There's nothing in your life that God doesn't already know. But if you put your trust in God, he'll fix it. See, the devil will tell you, you don't need God, you need to do this yourself. There is a way that seemeth right unto a man. It looks like you don't need God. But when it all comes to conclusion, you need God. I don't care how much money you got. I don't care how poor you are. I don't care how strong you are, nor how weak you are. The whole thing is, I need Jesus. Read. Oh, the depth of the riches, both of the wisdom and knowledge of God. How unsearchable are his judgments and his ways past finding out. Who have known the mind of the Lord? Or who have been his counselor? Who have first given to him? And it shall be or given unto him because of what he did. Recompense me. You give it back. Proverbs 1. I'm almost through. 22.
How long?
Ye simple ones.
Will ye love
simplicity?
And the scorners.
Delight in their scorning. They make fun. I listened to your congressman. The men that are supposed to be so smart. The ones that you look to help you. They want to bury you. You vote for them. Because they give you sweet talk. Tell you what they're going to do. Till they get the job. They don't even want you to have health care. That's because they got everything for them. And cares nothing about you. And you go along with them. But you got to understand God. The politician can't give it to you. It's God that gives you the provisions. It's God that makes a way out of no way. Mm-hmm. But you got to put your trust in him.
Yeah.
You got to bow down to him. Listen what he says.
How long are you simple
ones? Will ye love simplicity and scorners?
Delight in their scorning.
And fools hate knowledge. How long are you going to refuse to hear what God has to say? How long will you resist what God sends to you? You tell the preacher, I don't want to hear all that. God sent you here to hear it. Read.
Turn you.
He said, turn you.
At my reproof.
At my reproof. And at my instructions. At my correction. Turn. Turn. Change your ways. Read.
Behold.
I will pour out my spirit unto you.
I will make known my words
unto you.
Because I have called.
And ye refuse.
I have stretched out my hand.
And no man regarded.
But ye have set at naught.
All my counsel.
And with none of my reproof.
I also will laugh at your calamity. I will laugh at your trouble.
I will mock
when fear cometh. Listen, when God sends you a word, saints, we got to receive it. When God speaks to us, we got to open our heart. You see, God knows what's in your heart. And because he knows what's in your heart, he deals with you according to your mind. You want from God certain things so you can do what you want to do. And you want what you want so you can do what you want to do in spite of God's word. Because God gives us so much, we think we got it made. Read.
When your fear cometh as desolation.
And your destruction cometh as a whirlwind.
When distress and anguish cometh upon you.
Then shall they call upon me.
But I will not answer.
Ooh. God said he won't answer. Read.
They shall seek me early. But they shall not find me.
For that they hated knowledge.
Did not choose the fear of the Lord.
Listen. God wants you to be well. He wants to supply everything that you have need of. Everything you got is in God's control. He blessed you with everything that you wear. Everything that you eat, it's God's blessing. Everywhere you go, it's God's blessing that carries you there. God brings you to a place. He said, now I want you to listen to me. I want you to hear me. I want you to bring yourself to me. And I want you to receive. That's why I die. That's what God said.
Thank you, Jesus.
God laid down his life.
Yes, sir.
Glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody might say, well, that was Jesus. That's because he's God.
Yes, sir.
He laid down his life. Just so I can live. He doesn't want me to go to hell. He loved me so much that he shed his own blood. Great God Almighty. He loved me so much. He robed himself in flesh. Lord, help
us. Hallelujah.
He cared so much. He suffered and died just
Hallelujah.
For me. That's the reason. For the season.
Yes, sir. All right.
Because he loved me.
Thank you, Jesus.
Before I even knew. The reason for the season was that God could enter the world. They're still trying to figure out if Jesus is God. They're trying to figure out who he really is. And yet God told them. But they haven't received it. Great scholars are still searching the scriptures after all these centuries. And they haven't got to know him yet. But I want you to know that God has told us. He's given us to know just who he is. He is the living God. He is God Almighty. He is Jesus that walks in
the world.
All power in heaven and earth is in his hand. He laid down his life.
Hallelujah.
If he laid it down, he's got power to take it up again.
Thank you, Jesus.
This is the God that I serve.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Thank
you.
Thank you,
Jesus. And his name is Jesus. He's not a first, second, or third person.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
He's the only person.
Hallelujah.
In fact, all of the power of God is in Jesus.
Hallelujah.
All that God is.
Thank you, Jesus.
Is in Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Jesus is the Almighty God.
Yes, he is.
He's more than just a man. But he is. He was a man. He became a man.
Mm-hmm.
He's not a man that made himself God.
Yes, sir.
He is God that made himself man. God died for you. This is the reason for the season. And the season is not December 25th.
Right.
I don't know the date of his birth. It had to be around April or something like that. But I want you to know, the thing is, Jesus did come.
Hallelujah.
Jesus did die. Jesus did suffer.
Hallelujah.
Jesus did get up.
Hallelujah.
And he's coming back
Hallelujah.
Again. You need to get to know God. You need to get to know him. Because your life is at stake. The life that Jesus has given you was eternal life. But through the trick of the devil, he stole it from you. Now Jesus wants to return it. So he was willing to shed his blood. He was willing to die for you. Today he's made provisions. He has blinded the Jews for a little while. But they're getting ready to extol him. They're getting ready to exalt him. They're getting ready to claim him. And when they claim him, God's going to take his church out. God is going to take his church. And we've got to be ready. Somebody might ask, what must I do? Acts 2:38 tells us what to do. It says, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of your sin, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. We got clothing for men, women, and children. Somebody to baptize you in the name of Jesus. If you're here today and you desire to know God, you desire to know why God died on Calvary, this is the reason. All things are ready. If you desire to be saved, if you desire to walk with Jesus, and get a better understanding of what he wants from your life. Come even now, saying, I want to be saved. Come even now. Surrender yourself to Jesus. All things are ready. Will you come? Will you come? Will you let him into your life? Will you let him work the works of Christ in your life?
Oh, how he loves you.
Will you come?
Oh, how he loves you and me.
there just one? Is there just one that wants to go down in Jesus' name? Amen? For he is the reason for the season. Amen?
Amen.
And this is the only way to wash away your sins. That's in the name of Jesus. We're not going to worry your patience. Amen. We're not going to prolong the time. Amen. But we stand ready. Even if you have questions after service, feel free to come and ask your questions. Amen. Amen. At this time, we're going to ask the deacons to get the baskets for the offering. Amen. If you need an envelope, please raise your hand and the usher may bring you.